Oh, I'm stupid. This is a cassette player right here. Oh, radio. I forgot all about this room. What? That was a goat, a lion, and a bull. Why in the world would there just be animal sounds to make? A hint? Don't tell me it's like a Zodiac puzzle. Oh, I don't need to hear this again. It's a goat, a lion, and a bull. Oh, I didn't mean to hit it again! Okay, well that's the hint. I guess. Painting was hanging on the wall. It's 13th Zodiac. Alright. Yep, it was a Zodiac puzzle. I have no clue what their numbers are, but I'll look them up. So it's 13. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That makes no sense. Wow, this is really dumb, because there are 12. I didn't know there were 12. Why they say the snake was 13? Alright. Yeah, it's 10-5-2. I don't know why that's the answer. Because there are 12 zodiac animals, so the snake being 13, I don't have the patience to figure out why you would lie. Unless you subtract or something? I don't know, that's weird. Anyway, moving on to the story. Wow, what a beautiful looking bar. Hopefully nothing bad happens. The final part of the letter. My darling baby brother, I'll do whatever I can to prove my worth to you. Yesterday I went to town to prepare your test subjects for you as per usual. Just to see the happiness on your beautiful face. I'll listen to anything and everything you have to say. Then you told me the best news of my entire life. You asked me to become one of your test subjects tomorrow. This is so wonderful. I get to die about my younger brother. Die for my younger brother. Yeah, no, the novelist is the crazy one. Or, no, I'm sorry, wait, no, it's gotta be the bus driver then. No, the bus driver is the owner. I was like, it can't obviously be one of us because some of us are dead. No, actually, he was so fucking excited. He's rubbing himself because he's like, oh yeah, I get to get killed by my little brother. Like, it's so stupid. Wow. Seems so. Yep. Deed he was. But he mentioned that his... What is it, Nagito? I don't think I've ever heard that name before. Probably has his eyes on us right now. I see now. So that's how he did it. Have you figured it out? I want you to bring Himura and Nagishi here. I'm going to unravel this mystery once and for all. Yeah, brother. Alright. Well, while we wait, we might as well solve the puzzle, I guess. Ooh. Now... No, we'll put the case together. Detective, Ayaba's reability meter is displayed. Be aware that your deductions are proven wrong 3 times, you will receive a bad ending. Okay.
You already know who done it, Mr. Detective.
Why did he kill 3 people? Thank you for coming, everyone. Please listen to what I have to say, because I will start from the very beginning that led us to the crucial moment. Okay. Thank you for lending me your ears. First, let's look at the 2 cases that transpired here. Our first victim was Kataro Kashi, the bus driver. He died the first day from ingested poison from his meal. Then on the second day, two victims were killed, a crime fiction novelist and the carpenter. His neck was sliced open by a knife, then he bled out. Nyaka's heart was pierced with a bullet and he died instantly. There are some facts you need to know. Both men died around the same time. Then it was a locked room mystery, and murder weapons were never found. In short, we have one person killed. Two people were killed at the same time with two different murder weapons. Now I'll reveal who is the criminal mind behind the triple homicide. It was our partner. Now, who is to blame? Well, a part of me thinks, it's got to be him. This is the bus driver. It's got to be him. He is one of the victims, right? Well, unless he faked his death. Oh, no, he was a cold corpse. No, I guess it's not him. I knew it didn't make any sense, but I was like, it's gotta be one of the people that's alive. None of us. I think it might be none of us, but I don't know. They're not present here. What do you mean? The ones who executed these crimes are not one of us. Actually, it's fair to say that they're no longer in this world. Let's take it from the top, shall we? The one who poisoned. Well, I failed that. This is the bad ending. This is the bad ending. He just goes crazy because he can't figure it out. So he just admits to being the killer. It couldn't have been anybody but me because everyone loves to just keep accusing me. Then there were none. Okay. That's kind of funny. He's not present. Okay, yeah, so it was... Again, I'm kind of mixing up the names again. I'm sorry about that. But yeah, no, the bus driver is the one that ingested the poison himself as a sacrifice. Oh, yeah. Letter scraps. Just gonna believe what's on a piece of paper? Yep. These letters were addressed from an older brother to his younger brother. They are spread throughout the mansion. Let me read a line question. You asked me to become one of your test subjects tomorrow. This is so wonderful. I get to die for my younger brother. So you laid on intently died for his sibling. His older brother. And that would mean from the very start. Yep. He was both the victim and the assailant. Just to get some doubt into everybody's mind. It'd be much easier for... Yeah, he just... killed himself. Wait a second. And how... I get how he offed himself, but you're forgetting about the double murders. You're right. For the second murder involving the carpenter and the novel, the one behind it was... Well, it's the owner of the mansion. But did they kill each other? I want to say they killed each other. They did each other in? It has to be. They were locked in with each other. It's all because of that poison incident from the night before. Completely convinced that he did it. Didn't plan for his paranoia to result in murder, but he certainly he had a thought in his mind the entire time. He just killed him before he can kill him, but that's... I'm sure this was going through his mind. Thankfully, he had learned from unexpected good news that very same night that he was told he would get... which he was sure would give him the edge. The room on the third floor with all the weapons in it, right? Yeah, because he blabbed. The cook blabbed. Got himself the gun. Probably led him by claiming something along the lines of, "Help, he's after me." Naturally let him in, all while Mr. Nakai was hiding the knife from his back pocket. Locked the door behind him, and he attacked the novelist, and then he shot him with the gun. And then I started blasting. Didn't expect that he would pay a visit to the third floor and bring a weapon of his own. Okay, so that's where the weapons went. But then they were taken. Oh, I forgot about that. But it seems we were on the right track. They had no reason to be afraid of the killer on the loose. Oh, yeah, that's right. He did a whole 180 because he had a gun on him. He was completely safe. Whereas the other night, he didn't have a weapon. That makes a lot of sense. Fired his gun the same time he landed his own attack. That's crazy. Well, it's not crazy. Here's the scenario I'm proposing. He acted too rashly and attacked first, but he was a bit quicker. Then the carpenter fell back from force and he died instantly. Novice fell forward, pouring blood out from his artery being cut. Then he started blasting. Love that meme. Hold on there. If what you're claiming is true, then they shouldn't have, shouldn't they have been clasping on their respective murder weapons? He has a point. They killed each other at the same time, and the weapons should still be there. Hate to break it to you, but I actually found one of the murder weapons not long ago. Where'd you find it? Oh, you see, I found it inside, my guest room, right? The simple truth is that with the second incident, there must have been a third party here tempered with the crime scene. Third party? The person responsible for tampering with the crime scene of the double homicide was... a ghost. Not me. The owner of the mansion. You recall the younger brother mentioned the letters in the scraps, right? His younger brother is clearly the owner of the mansion. He said himself, "I had transported these test subjects to your mansion, then observed their behavior closely." Do you recall his younger brother's name? It was Nagito, right? Correct again. Good work. The owner of this mansion is behind everything. He even went through all his efforts to manipulate the crime scene, all to implicate and entrap me. So you're saying that this owner, the mastermind, is still working from the shadows to get us? He's not lurking in the shadows any longer, for he's right in front of us. Nakita Kishi. There was a name hidden inside there. If we were to rearrange the letters, we would get... Oh, shit. Huh. It's not Kenshi. Oh, boy. Wait, what? I guess, yeah. Who would be dumb enough to create a new name using the, this is right, right? Yeah, it looks like it. Then I start blasting. This is interesting. Wait, wait, there, oh no, there is a K. Yeah, who would be dumb to mix their current name and make a new name out of the letters of their own name? That's weird. I should try that. I think I fucked that up. Yeah, because I didn't actually put the space there. Should have realized. Right? Ah, fuck. Put the space right over here. There we go. It's gotta be, this... Yeah. I'm glad they put the list of suspects here, or else I would have never been able to spell the name. Wow. Who would be dumb enough to do that? He's the responsible for this, the mastermind in the shadows. But now I've unveiled your true nature, Toa. Or should I refer to your real name as Nagito? It was the cook. Well. You gotta stop randomly pointing fingers at everyone, Mr. Anaba. I'm the mastermind. Are you serious? That's impossible. Are you purposely trying to sway the conversation in favor to distract everyone from the knife I found in your guest room? Please, I'd like to hear your explanation for this. Go ahead. You planted it there to frame me. And where is this evidence of yours? Oh, do you really want to know? Are you pulling my leg? Out with it, man. I want to see the so-called evidence you have. As you wish. It's your grave you're digging. The vital piece of evidence that exposes the owner of the mansion as the one who manipulated the crime scene was... Soul in your shoe. The criminal evidence that exposes the owner of the mansion is the sole of your shoe. Because there was a footprint there, a very small foot. You got tiny feet, bro. It's funny because I don't really know that for sure, but it's gotta be. Remember the pools of blood that formed during Mr. Komatsu and, you know, the carpenter and the novelist? Apparently the killer was careless and left a footprint there. I personally made sure to take extra care around the blood's pools, not to step on them myself. Furthermore, they also didn't go further into the room, thus preserving the crime scene. In short, the killer should have only wanted to have some blood shed on the bottom of their shoe. Judging from the footprints on the carpet, it would be only the smallest smudges. The fact that it's so minuscule is exactly why they're fortunate. The killer would have never noticed that he stepped onto a small droplet of blood. Therefore, I think it's about time we check the bottoms of everyone's shoes. If we do that, this will reveal the true culprit. Ever a sharp one, Amora. So we're waiting for. Anyone feel like burying their soul to me? Huh. You're incredible. You certainly earned your title as a great detective. Of course, my stupid brother had to go write such a drive. Such a drive. Can't expect anything from a bonehead like him. Seriously. He made every single little thing 100 times more difficult. Like, what the hell, man? Leaving behind cryptic hints can be a form of entertainment, but I specifically instructed not to include any names. Does Kotaro have wax in his ears or what? I can't believe anyone would be so incompetent. It's all his fault I've been found out. Wow. Why are you still calling me by that name? Did you not listen to anything our detective friend had to say? My name is Nagito. Try not to forget it, okay? This can't be real. Please tell us you're joking. I thought I told you worthless pieces of trash to call me by my proper name. How many people have you killed? It could be, did our private dick crack this case wide open? Now somebody give this guy an award. What are you saying? Based on the letter scraps, I've deduced that our mastermind here has repeated this exact same scenario countless times before to an art form. But they obviously picked the wrong people to bring. A really smart detective. Anyone who came to this mansion but were test subjects for his literacy work. You mean those murder mystery books? Hats off to you, man. Here I encompassed everything essential in creating the perfect murder mystery. The killer's philosophy, or psychology. The victim's raw emotions, and above all, keeping the illusion consistent. So you were the author behind those murder mystery novels. Are you telling me that you've read them? Because my murder mystery masterpieces are absolutely without peer. Nothing could even compare to them. Especially because all of them are based on real people and real events. Oh my god. Then all those deaths in the book, they really happened? No shit. You're out of your mind. However, all those other books are going to pale in comparison to this one. I can't wait to start writing it. Oh, you have done yourself this time. You're insane to kill it with such empty reasons. What? I'm writing him in a book. It's the ultimate art. So that they laid a single finger on them. They all died of their own volition. How could you say such things? Don't, Amora. Nothing we say matters at this point. I totally underestimated you, Mr. Inaba. You actually arrived at the truth of the matter, didn't you? But now we have a slight dilemma. I can't have anyone spoil the ending of my novel before it's finished. I have one last request for you all. For the sake of art, could you all just... die? Everyone here with me, we've got to escape. Oh, come on, don't start padding my novel with this foolish nonsense. I will save my progress, because I think we're running. And we are running. Up. Skip chase sequence? No. I'm not gonna skip it. Everybody wants to see this. See me fail over and over. Oh shit. Luckily I'm- oh my god, he's fast. At least it looks that way. Oh shit. You mother- oh shit. Wait, what? I will take a knife. I guess that saves me from one hit, maybe. Oh shit. Run! Oh, you f- I like the music. What the- I was stuck on the table for some reason. Also, the house appears to be falling apart. Ah, oh, you spunk. What the- Oh my god. Wait, what? Oh, I thought I got a game over or some shit. Storage room. Wait, what? What? Oh no. I have to sit. What the fuck? I like the music, but damn. I need to find an item to pull them up. Oh god. I don't know what to get. Can I get a bed sheet? Like, what the fuck? Well, alright. This is weird. Potted plant, help me. This is very unique, though. I like this. Can I use the bed sheet? No? Did I go to bed? Oh, fuck. Oh, I found a rope. Oh, I can't save. Save my assistant first. All the ropes snapped. I am not leaving you behind. Hold on a minute. We will come rescue you. Just relax. Is that a gun, Doctor? You had a weapon on your s- What? What the fu- Oh, this is bad. Doctor, don't. You're kidding me.
I didn't mean it.
Holy shit, you're kidding me. I'm not leaving you behind. What the fuck was that? You panicked. Oh shit.
Well, now, ghost.
Oh my god. Doctor. Oh shit. What is this? I'm more seriously dead? Oh, that sucks. Wow. Isn't she lucky? Jeez saves me all the effort of killing her. Imagine a reader shocked to learn that the poor heroine died from the hands of the people she trusts. It writes itself. Are you suffering inside, Mr. Inaba? Can't you feel that gut-wrenching churn in your stomach? Don't worry, my friend. You won't have to feel that way long. I'm sending you off to meet her. How dare you speak ill of her? What's this? Are you feeling a raw essence of pure, unfiltered resentment coming from you? Oh, it's so nice to be you. You don't want to live without the sweet, your sweet Amora. Do you? You want her to be all... You don't want her to be all alone, right? Come on, I'm offering you a one-way ticket to meet her, courtesy of this blade. What? What? I warned you. Now you'll never disrespect the dead again. Oh, but I don't want her to be dead. No. 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 No, 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 no. This can't be the ending I want. Wait, can I not leave? Am I jumping down? What the fuck? Oh, I got the front door key. Now this is... Hopefully she isn't dying. Yeah, let's fuck her. Like... That can't be right. Instead of our bus waiting for us at the other end, the police officer standing by, and at last I was finally safe from that living hell. I learned that there was never a landslide in the first place, and we were treated as missing person. What? Then that landslide we saw back there was an illusion? Projected by the ghosts of the mansion? What? Or they were guiding us to break the chain of death perpetuated by the sadistic brothers? What the fuck? I told police everything that happened in the mansion, and everything. I kept one thing to myself. I'll come back to this mansion again someday to meet the other passengers on that bus. Curtains fall in that particular mystery file, it'll be one I can never forget. Especially considering the crime I had committed. A crime that'll follow me through my life. Yeah, because you murdered a man, bro. Wow. Unpardonable crime. Hold on, no. We're not ending it there. Oh, wait, I loaded the wrong save file. Not that one. Okay, we'll get the doctor first. That's kind of funny. Please hold on the rope. I'm glad we got that ending. What about Amora? All we can do is find the key to open the storage room and back it up. Please wait there, we'll come get you. You better, mister. I'm gonna haunt your office if I don't get out of here. I like her spunk. Oh shit. Man, shut the fuck up. So we resume the hunt? How about no? How about no and say we did? Alright, what am I supposed to do now? Oh shit. What am I gonna do? There's nowhere left to run, you know. Well, that reminds me. It's not like it'd matter in the end. You don't have to have... You don't even have a key to the front doors. What should we do? What? The lights. Damn, now what? Ah, well, this changes nothing. There's some mood lighting for the grand finale. Still can't escape from here. Aw, the ghosts are gonna help, aren't they? What was that? Oh, it is the ghosts.
Who's saying that? Show yourselves. Are there other people here with us? Get the fuck away from me.
Oh my god, they're kicking his ass.
I can't breathe. Help. Help.
Wow. Sweet revenge. Why didn't they do this earlier? It would have been confusing as fuck, but anyway.
It's too dark to see anything. Good thing I have a light on me.
I can now save my progress, thank god. Holy shit. I should not touch these ghosts. It turned this into like a maze. I have the front door key. Let's get the hell out of here, not...
Amora. Get the hell out of here.
Took your sweet time.
I was going as fast as I could.
Let's not argue. We saved you. Aw.
Is that you? Something feels off about her demeanor. I have a really bad feeling.
Oh no, she's a ghost.
Aw, shit. This isn't good. We have to run.
Oh no.
Up! Oh, I almost... Oh, we did it.
Oof. I almost touched that ghost.
I'm sorry. I can't help it. First of all, you came at me. Okay, that's the one main issue here. I have a life. Your life's over, unfortunately.
We're finally safe from that living hell. I learned that there was a landslide in the first place and we were treated as missing persons.
That, yeah, there was never a landslide.
So the ghosts created the landslide? No one bothered? Well, I mean, if you saw a landslide, you wouldn't go over and touch it to see if it was real.
Wow. After I told the police what had happened in that mansion, I later returned in order to meet the rest of the other passengers. Not a single soul remained in that mansion. Not even the remains of, everybody was discovered. All I could do was bury Kitty's remains with their proper grave.
Aw. I'll never forget this either.
This is a nice little game. This was really cool.
I'm glad I played it. I hope the people who wanted me to play this are happy.
Very well made.
And yeah, I really like these two characters. They're cute. I have a fondness over, like, animes or shows that I watch where you have the one guy who is completely thick-headed, confident, smart, but he's kind of like... Not shy, but he's just kind of like, a jerk. And then you have the one girl who's always his friend. Probably there's a love interest there, but you know, it's kind of like it reminds me like a lot of Inuyasha, where Inuyasha won't, like the male character won't admit that he has feelings for the girl, but they do. They're friends, and it doesn't take. It takes like a moment for them. To being like in such crazy danger to see like the actual love there. I don't know. But I like this character. He's very smart. And so is the girl too.
I just didn't expect there to be like a ghost and stuff like that. Like that was pretty sick.
But yeah, definitely interesting. Like, you know, I played this an hour last night and I'm just beating it today. And sometimes like, I don't know, with names like this and the characters looking kind of similar, like, especially Japanese names, I had trouble kind of remembering who was who, so I apologize for that, but it was still fun. That's why I can't say their names fully, because I can't say them right, and I'm definitely not going to remember them either, but it is what it is. Ooh. What's the next case?
Milk and sugar?
Just how you like it. I like the music, too. If you hate bitterness so much, I can't understand why you bother drinking coffee at all. You're trying to emulate those dark, handsome, hard-boiled egg type detectives. Care to repeat that? And he keeps pulling her cheek, I forgot about that. Our next client? Oh, hello. You look well. Are you getting plenty of rest? Would you like a lollipop? Don't treat me like a child. Just having a bit of fun with you. Just gonna let the doctor stand out there, or you're gonna invite them in for a chat?
Of course.
Doctor, it's unusual for you to come here. Is there anything in particular that you need?
As a matter of fact, yes, I would like to request your services.
It's a new case.
Looks like we're gonna get paid this month.
Are you claiming you didn't get paid last month?
Well, no, because we kind of were put into an... we had to solve a case that we kind of accidentally fell into.
You know, I pay based on case and performance skills.
Naturally, if that's the case, then I'll earn a fortune this time as Detective Inaba's number one assistant.
You were just waiting for an opportunity to say that, weren't you?
You read me like a book.
Now then, let's hear about this case of yours while I gently sip on this morning cup of coffee.
On to the next case.
Is the nurse going to be a reoccurring character?
Maybe.
It's her case anyway.
Alright, well that's the Let's Play. I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know what you'd like to see. When I get the chance, I will play the second case and third case, which third case is like the newest game that came out. Seeing people play it. Looking forward to it. So hopefully you guys are having a good day, and I'll see you next time. Peace out.